in Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach.
Elie Seckbach reporting.
For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.
For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.
Center. This man has nothing to be ashamed of. He came up short against Gervonta Davis, one of the best fighters on the planet. What an effort, what energy, what drama here in Los Angeles. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Isaac Pitbull CRUZ. Round of applause for the challenger. Came up short tonight. And Martin, if you can ask him what are his thoughts, as we are only barely, not even an hour removed from what was a tremendous fight here in Los Angeles.
Ha pasado menos de una hora desde una pelea tremenda acá en Los Ángeles. Contanos lo que te pasa por la cabeza, lo que pensás, tus sentimientos.
Estoy muy feliz por el gran desempeño que acabo de hacer contra un gran peleador. Y bueno, más que nada agradecerle a toda la gente que asistió al Staples Center y a toda la gente que estuvo al pendiente en sus casas. Y gracias por el apoyo. Se dio una gran pelea y bueno, un gran espectáculo a la gente y ustedes fueron los ganadores.
I'm very happy for the way that I fought against a top-notch opponent. And I want to thank the fans that were at Staples Center and also tuning in on pay-per-view. You guys got a great show and I'm glad that we were able to entertain you in a way that made for a great fight tonight.
Sean Gibbons, on behalf of MB Promotions, how proud are you of what you saw out of Isaac CRUZ against Gervonta Davis tonight?
I couldn't be prouder for Isaac and his father. He exceeded expectations. I think a lot of people thought he shouldn't be in this fight. That's why we fight the fights. We don't fight him on paper. We don't fight him on Twitter. We fight him in the ring. And that's what Isaac CRUZ did. And you don't need to be a belt to be a winner. This man's a winner tonight. And we're looking forward to returning to PBC. And Al Heyman was ecstatic about the fight, so.
And I gotta give everybody.
We don't need the WBA, we got Al Heyman.
I wanna give everyone a round of applause. Mayweather Promotions for making this fight happen, and Gervonta Davis for immediately accepting this fight. So if we have questions from the media, raise your hand. Kyle, go ahead, and we got Keith Idick first to ask Isaac CRUZ a question.
My question is for Isak and for Sean, if you could. I'm sure you heard Gervonta Davis' answer. He said, hell no, when they asked him about doing a rematch. What are your thoughts on him not wanting a rematch?
Bueno, la pregunta para Isaac es, ¿qué opinan de cuando Gervonta Davis dijo, no, ni loco, cuando le preguntaron sobre la revancha? ¿Qué te generó eso?
Algo inexplicable. ¿Por qué? De un peleador que no lo conocían, lo conocieron de la mejor manera y contra un gran oponente de los mejores 135, se negó a darnos la revancha.
That I can't explain it. It's crazy. How did it go from someone that he didn't know at 135 to someone that he wants to avoid at all costs for a rematch? It's absolutely astounding. Sean?
You know, a lot of people always talk about Tank Davis being a dumb person. I think he's the smartest guy in this room because he realized tonight who Isaac CRUZ Jr. was. He tried to intimidate him on numerous occasions. He tried to intimidate him at the weigh-in. And all Isaac did was fight harder and almost run him out of the ring. It should be more like Gervonta Rigondeaux, but we'll go with Davis for now. But again, Isaac has a bright future. He's 23 years old. If Gervonta doesn't want to give him the rematch, then that's his business, but we have a lot of big fights and a lot of good things in front of Isaac.
Isaac, aquí. Felicidades por la gran pelea que nos diste esta noche. Isaac, ¿qué crees que te faltó hacer hoy para que los jueces te dieran más rounds y pudieras ganar la pelea? Y la segunda pregunta es, ¿qué tan fuerte pega Gervonta Davis a comparación de los otros rivales que has enfrentado?
Well, Isaac, the question is, what was missing today to maybe flip a couple of rounds in your favor and come out with the win? And then, how does Gervonta compare to past opponents that you faced?
Pega duro, claro. Pero para eso nos preparamos nosotros bien, para aguantar todo lo que nos iba a presentar. Nunca nos lastimó, ustedes lo vieron. Claro, no somos unos perfectos en el ring, pero lo hicimos ver mal a él también.
He's a hard puncher, that's for sure. But we prepared well, and as you can see, he didn't do any real damage at all. So we felt prepared, and we felt that we stood up to him just fine during the 12 rounds.
Isaac, tú te llevaste los halagos de todo el mundo y nació un ídolo mexicano el día de hoy.
Well, Isaac, everybody's praising you right now, and it feels like a new Mexican hero was born tonight. What do you think about that?
Claro, yo lo dije. Iban a ser una nueva estrella mexicana para los aficionados, para los latinos y para todo el mundo, y se cumplió.
Did I tell you or did I tell you? A new Mexican star was going to be born, and that's exactly what happened tonight. So I'm proud to be able to perform like that for you guys, and I'm glad it came out that way.
Isaac over here. Gervonta Davis said that he hurt his left hand after the sixth round. Do you feel you were fighting a different fighter after the sixth round?
Gervonta dijo que se lastimó la mano izquierda después del sexto round. ¿Sentí que la pelea cambió, dio un giro después de aquel sexto asalto?
Creo que ahorita las excusas salen sobrando. Yo peleé con un nudillo lastimado. No puse pretextos. Di batalla y aquí estamos para la revancha si es que nos la da.
Seems like the excuses are plenty right now. I fought with Bruce Knuckles also, but I didn't make any excuses. You know, I fought the way I fought, he fought the way he thought. There shouldn't be any excuses. The fight was the way that it was.
And were you happy with the judges' scoring of the fight? Because there was quite a few rounds that clearly you won, but apparently the judges felt otherwise.
Bueno, ¿qué opinaste del veredicto de los jueces? ¿Te pareció que fue justo o que fue un poco injusto?
Creo que el mejor juez es el público.
I think the best judge actually are the fans.
More questions for Isaac Pitbull Krause. I think Ellie's got a question. I'll get to Ellie soon.
So, I don't need a mic.
No, go ahead, Ellie.
Okay, so Isaac, two things. Did you and Gervonta talk after the fight? What did you say? And also, who would you want next?
Did you hear him? He said if him and Gervonta talk.
Bueno, si hablaste con Gervonta después de la pelea.
Claro. Como todo buen boxeador, tanto como él como yo, fuimos enemigos arriba del ring. Abajo nos dimos la mano como todo un gran caballero, de su parte como de la mía. Y bueno, nos dijo que éramos unos grandes peleadores, que teníamos mucho corazón como todo mexicano.
Of course, we are gentlemen outside the ring, just like we're fighters inside of you. And we talked afterwards, he said I was a great fighter, that had a lot of heart. And that, you know, he admired the way that I fought. And, you know, that's the way it should be. Gentlemen outside the ring, shaking hands, and then what happens inside the ring stays inside the ring.
And who does he want next?
Who does he want next?
¿A quién quieres como oponente a futuro?
A quien me dé la oportunidad.
Whoever gives me a chance.
Sean.
Whoever gives me a chance is going to go next.
Basically, you know, he's ranked still across the board in the top 10. So anybody that we can work our way back up towards fighting for a world title, and we'll speak with Al Haymon, PBC, and we'll see what's next.
More questions?
Mohammed Mubarak with the Electronic Airline Report. Throughout the fight, there were moments where we were in tussles with him, like wrestling with him. Were you expecting that type of fight? And did you see any surprises? Coming from him.
Hubo momentos sumamente agresivos en esta pelea, muy reñida. Pero hubo algo que te haya sorprendido de él, algo que no hayas visto venir y dijiste, uya, no la vi venir a esa.
Nunca habíamos visto a un Gervonta pasivo, nervioso y de alguna manera temeroso. Algo que nosotros le acabamos de hacer es dar lo máximo, sacarlo de su zona de confort.
That was our best achievement, really. The surprise was the fact that I had never seen a Gervonta that was passive, almost afraid, really. So we were able to take him out of his comfort zone, and I'm proud of the fact that we were able to do just that.
Yeah, Andre Johnson's interviews. You fought a tremendous fight, and I know you felt you won the fight, but the judges did not give it to you. Is there anything you thought you could have done differently, given that you fought a great fight, but you did not get the decision?
Bueno, más o menos la pregunta de antes es que si hubiese podido hacer algo distinto, ¿qué hubiese sido para poder ganar la pelea? ¿Sentiste que hubo algo que te faltó?
Una caída para poderme llevar la victoria.
Maybe, yeah, a knockdown. If I had knocked him down, perhaps I would have won the fight.
Isaac, Adriana Jimenez of Fino Boxing. First of all, congratulations on a spectacular performance. Obviously, Gervonta said he's not interested in a rematch for you. Does that leave the names of Kambosis, Haney, Lomachenko, Ryan Garcia? Are those names that interest you that you're going to be asking for? Esos nombres que mencioné son peleas que vas a buscar, que vas a pedir con después de esta tremenda actuación.
Por supuesto, yo estoy para quien me diga Al Haymon, Showtime, Manny Pacquiao, para quien sea. Vieron que un nuevo guerrero mexicano no se cae contra los mejores y estoy dispuesto a pelear con quien sea.
Well, you know, it's really, I'm ready for whoever, Al Haymon, Showtime, and, you know, the promoters say that I have to face. I'm not afraid of absolutely anybody.
Steve?
Isaac, congratulations on a great performance. You caught Gervonta a few times, it seemed like. Were you surprised that he was able to take your power that well? And was there any point in the fight where you felt maybe you did have him hurt at all?
Bueno, lo pudiste lastimar a Gervonta un par de veces. ¿Te sorprendió que él haya podido absorber tu poder de la manera en que lo hizo? Y de otra manera también, ¿sentís que lo lastimaste de una manera severa en algún momento?
Sí, claro. Ahora sí que se notó. Nos abrazaba, hacía dos, tres marrullerías. Se sintió lastimado. Le demostramos que también le demostramos poder en la pelea.
Of course, you know how I know I hurt him? Because he was trying to embrace me, he was trying to grab me when he was hurt, and it was evident.
Isaac, primeramente felicidades en una gran pelea. En esta pelea, ¿qué aprendiste en esta pelea? ¿Qué aprendiste y ir para adelante? ¿Sientes que ya la...
In Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach.
Elie Seckbach reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.